So I love Jim Cornette. Jim's
Oh,
always been
yeah.
so good to me. I've done Smoky Mountain TV before. He booked me as an extra for WWE whenever he could. Whenever he came to Northeast, he'd manage me and Devin Storm Crowbar as a team. Love Jim. I remember at Smoky Mountain TV one time, he's going ballistic, and I looked at Chris Candido and I'm like, what's
Yeah.
going on? He's like, just ignore it. It's just
Yeah.
that's just what happens. It's fun.
Yeah.
Any classic Cornette rant stories you can talk about?
Oh, let's see. Well, I love Jim. Jim, JR, Stone Cold, and Danny Davis saved my job because they were going to cut me, not even give me a chance to go up top. And Jim wrote a letter saying, you got to pay him for 90 days anyway. Why don't you just bring him up? Maybe he'll think of something. So I'm ever in debt to Jim for that, Danny, Stone Cold, and let's see, Jimmy, Danny, Stone Cold,
Jim Ross.
Jim Ross, and Kenny Bolin, because they were all,
Kenny's on my list.
yeah. And
to
they
knock him
all
out.
fought for me to go up, and we did. And but Cornette stories, I man, in the Smoky Mountain territory, he went nuts on a guy, almost beat him with a baseball bat, chased the guy all the way to the roof, you know.
Terry Landau?
It must have been, I don't know, we were wrestling somewhere in Tennessee, I don't
Yeah.
know, too many steel chairs, I forget
Oh,
things. But I mean, Jim only got upset at me once, but I've seen him fly off the handle on a lot of guys. And one great thing about Jimmy, if he gets upset at you and explodes at you, as fast as he explodes at you, as fast as he forgets it.
right.
He doesn't carry a grudge. I forgot to poke a referee in the eye during a TV main event, and I got chastised. But what was good for me is I became a heel and I got on Kenny Bolin's team. And Jim and Kenny had known each other for years. So
Right.
Jim come out and tell us what we need to do. And I'd go, look right at Kenny, go, what do you mean? And Kenny goes, he means this, this, that, this, and that. So I had the inside scoop.
Nice.
So I never misunderstood Jimmy. And he was my biggest fan when I first got there. I always did what he said. I never ever said, well, I don't want to do that or nothing like that. Whatever
Right.
they told me to do, I did. And like I said, Jim Cornette believed in me. Dr. Tom did. Danny did. I worked with Stone Cold once with JR. I was always in the Ross Report in the lower leagues. JR was my biggest fan
Got
too.
it.
And I am as much for them.
Can you talk to me about working with a young John Cena?
Yeah. I went from face to heel,
Okay.
and I was with Bowling Services, and John got the developmental contract, and
Plug it in.
instead of Rico the American Gladiator champion, I was Rico the role model
Okay.
when I went
Was it?
heel.
Was it it wasn't was it a model like appearance play on words like you like the stylist
Role
almost?
model, role model.
Okay.
I'm going to show you people in Louisville how to live. You are
Okay.
backwood country bumpkins. That's what you all are. And when you
Got
say Louisville, they go crazy.
I
It's
can imagine.
Louisville. It's Louisville. And I used to bag on Kenny and I used to. We almost got beat up in Huntington, West Virginia at a radio station for what we were doing. They came down to the state, stole Kenny Bolin's briefcase. Everything. We had to run to the hotel. John was very professional. I love John. And I don't have to tell you he's a master on the mic. And Bolin's very good on the mic. And here I am mixed with these guys, so I got better on the mic. John was easy to work with. He listened to Cornette too. And we made a good heel team. Is when we get the funny thing is they knew to boo us and stuff like that, but when we took on like Disciples of Sin and stuff like that, we were getting cheered. When two heel team Jim put two heel teams against each other, and we were getting cheered. So, like I said, John, extraordinary athlete, very strong, good work ethic, always showed up, always did what he was supposed to do and stuff like that. I'm glad I had him as a partner because we all made it work. I haven't talked to John since OVW, but
What about main roster? You weren't on the main roster with John?
yeah. Oh, we
What
saw
was he
each other in the
like?
locker room.
What was
Same
he like
John.
going from, from to be the top guy, same John?
Well, he was becoming the top guy. He wasn't the
Okay.
top guy yet. He was doing the heel thing, thugonomics, and all that stuff, which Vince didn't understand, the chain on the neck and stuff like that. So he was just getting that off the hook, right around 04, 05, right around there. And I wrestled John a couple times. And I wrestled as a heel. He was a face when he was still wearing the trunks, like his boots and trunks would match
They'll match. How many
the
pairs did he have?
he had, I don't know. He had every pair of boots, shorts, wherever he was, he matched the state college,
Yeah,
wherever it
crazy.
was. Yeah, he had, I don't know, he must have had a whole apartment full. But he did it, and that's what he did. So like I said, he was just climbing when I was still there. Then I was released. Vince wouldn't give me a raise. That's why I quit.
So when you're in OVW, besides Jim Cornette, who actually like took you under the wing, taught you the most, taught you the ins and outs of, because there's got to be a big difference between training at a wrestling school and training in OVW.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, anybody who would give me tips, I'd listen to. Rip Rogers was a major factor also. I keep forgetting to mention him. Rip Rogers, a wealth of knowledge, psychology, extraordinary. He's got a master's degree in psychology, and so Rip Rogers, Danny used to work with me late at night when he'd be editing. I'd be at the the old Jeffersonville thing, running the ring, practicing the bumps and stuff like that. He'd come out and show me, things, techniques and stuff like that. I was always there. I lived basically at that school, at OVW.
Talk to me about a young Brock Lesnar.
Brock came in eager, hungry. You had a good work ethic, listened. Like I said, everybody that came in, I was the first guy in OVW as a contract guy. And Jim, like I said, we're going to go back to Jim real quick. Jim saw something in me because then we had OVW, we had Power Pro, and we had Heartland. And I was training so hard, Jimmy let me hold the OVW, Power Pro, and Heartland heavyweight titles all at the same time.
Nice.
In 99, I had all three belts. Or 2000, I had all three belts. And I
Wow.
was driving and doing shows. So I got to know Jim very well and listen to him, listen to what he said, psychology. He was great. Jim was great.
Any social media you want to plug? Any way if someone wants to get in touch with
Well,
you or promoter?
yeah, if you do, Kenny Bolin, that's one, or Renee Dupree. Renee helps, Renee Ford stuff. And there's a gentleman in South Korea named Terry Jong. He's put together the Rico Costantino appreciation page, and he runs it. And when the fans write in, it gives an instant message. Thank you for messaging. We'll get right back to you. But I will tell you, it is me that answers the questions. Terry doesn't answer anything. It's me. And when if you write, it is me who is replying to you. Because I get, is this really Rico? Yes.
What platform is that on? Is that on Facebook? Is that on?
Facebook. Yeah,
Okay.
Facebook. I
Are you
don't
on
do social
Facebook
media.
yourself? Okay.
I have a Facebook page because when I was sick, Kenny Boland did a GoFundMe. So
Okay.
I have a Facebook page. I know I have a Twitter account somewhere and a TikTok account, but it's not me. It's
Got it.
somebody being me. So I
Got it.
don't do the social media. The internet knows enough about me. They really do. So Renee Dupree on Cafe de Renee or Kenny Boland, they can always get a hold of me, you know, and if they know I'm doing this, they know you have my number.
Sure. Yeah.
If they want to contact you,
Absolutely.
you know.
Absolutely.